In this video, I'm going to take you through how to run the Zed report. This is a very simple and useful report that we can use within particular date ranges to show active and non-active accounts and their balances. So up on your toolbar, let's go to the Reports button. And then all the way down to the bottom, you'll see the Zed report. So just click here. And in the next window, we can put in our date range. So for the first report I'm going to show you, let's just put in today's date. So we can just go down to the today's date button and then click in the to field, and we can hit the button again as well. So we've just got today's date. If we wanted to change that day, we can use the plus or minus buttons for day, month, and year, and also beginning of month, end of month, and the same for the year as well. So let's hit on OK. And when we run this report, we want to make sure that the orientation is on landscape. So select landscape and OK. Now, as I'm on a Mac, I can open this in a PDF just to show you in a preview. So let's just do that right here. And you'll see we have another window come up saying if we want to print our active accounts or all accounts. So for this example right now, I'm just going to show you what happens if we click on active accounts. So it's just going to show us all the accounts that had activity in the date range that we just outlined. And that was just in today's date range. So this is all of the active accounts for today. So you'll see that we have our US dollars, and then we also have our foreign currencies. So we have our opening balance for the day, quantity purchased, quantity sold, any transfers in and out, closing balance for the day. Then we have our cost of purchase, which is in our home currency, and then our gross sales, which is also in our home currency. So you'll see under the US dollars, the cost of purchase is going to be the same as the quantity purchased because it's the same currency. And our gross sales is going to be the same as quantity sold. But if we come down to our foreign currencies, you'll see that 750 Australian dollars were sold, which is the equivalent to $557.54 in US dollars, our home currency. So that's our gross sales in our home currency. Same goes for the cost of purchase. So it cost us $686.21 in US dollars, our home currency, but we purchased 1,000. So that's the equivalent in the home currency. You'll also notice that all the way over to the very end, we have the unrealized gain. So we have that based on the market value at the time of the transaction. And at the bottom, we also have the grand totals of our gross sales and our cost of purchase. So a very simple, easy report. I'm going to do it one more time though. I'm going to show you the difference between clicking on active accounts and all accounts. So back up onto our toolbar, clicking on reports and down to the Z report again. So in the date range, we can keep it as today's date, or we can change it a little bit. We can say beginning of the month, let's say, and then up until today's date. Click on OK. Make sure the orientation's landscape and OK. I'm going to preview this in PDF. And instead of clicking on active accounts, this time we're going to click on all accounts. So once this report's generated, it's going to show you all of our accounts that we have, whether they were active or not within that date range. So you'll see that we've got some banks and we've got our opening balance, but there was nothing purchased, nothing sold or transferred, and so we have our closing balance, which should be the exact same. But then you'll see that lower down in our cash accounts, we have some activity. So we have some quantity purchased and sold, and what that was in our home currency, our cost of purchase and our gross sales. And then the same if we keep going down, we've got all of our accounts, our expense, our foreign currencies, showing all the activity that we've had in the last month. And then we have the grand totals at the bottom. And so this is the Zed report based on a date range that we enter in ourselves, showing our accounts, whether they're active or not, with our closing balances and our cost of purchase and our gross sales.